Ang supernatural na paglipat ng Diyos sa Gaza bilang daan-daang iniulat na nakilala si Jesus sa panaginip. Mahigit 200 Muslim sa Gaza ang naiulat na humiling na sundan si Jesus matapos siyang makilala sa panaginip. Ang professor ng Kristiyano at presidente ng Risen Jesus Inc., si Michael Licona, ay nagsabi na nakatanggap siya ng isang ulat mula sa underground Christian ministry sa Palestine na nagdedetalye ng mahimalang mga conversion. Ang Diyos ay gumagawa sa gitna ng digmaan. Ibinahagi niya kamakailan sa isang post sa Facebook. Sa nakalipas na 2 araw, naglingkod kami sa daan-daang ama na nawala ng karamihan kung hindi man lahat sa kanilang mga anak sa digmaan. Nang ilipat namin ang mga lalaking ito sa ligtas na lugar, pinakain namin sila, nilabhan ang kanilang mga damit at nagsimulang basahin ang Biblia sa kanila. Pagbabahagi ng daan ng kapayapaan sa pamamagitan ni Jesus nagtatanong kung paano sundin si Jesus, sinipi ni Licona mula sa Ministeryong Kristiyano. Si Licona ay isang professor sa Houston Christian University at nagsulat ng ilang mga libro kabilang ang The Case for the Resurrection of Jesus at Paul Meets Muhammad. Ang dating Muslim na naging Christian apologist na si Nabil Qureshi ay minsang sumulat, si Mike Licona ay naging instrumento sa aking paglalakbay palabas ng Islam tungo kay Kristo. Habang ako ay isang Muslim na estudyante sa kolehiyo, regular akong inayahan ni Mike sa kanyang tahanan upang talakayin ang pagiging makasaysayan ng pagkamatay ni Jesus noong krus. At ang kanyang pagkabuhay na mag-uli mula sa mga patay ay napakalakas ng ebidensya na ipinakita ni Mike na siyang naging pangunahing bato ng aking pagbabalik loob mula noon. Nakita kong napakalakas ng epekto ng kanyang gawain sa libu-libo sa makasaysayang ebidensya ng pananampalatayang Kristiyano. Idinagdag ni Licona sa kanyang post na ang ulat ay dapat ipagdiwang ng mga Kristiyano sa buong mundo. Kampi ako sa Israel sa digmaang ito. Hindi kinakailangan para sa teolohikong mga kadahilanan, ngunit dahil ang Hamas at ang mga sumusuporta dito ay purong kasamaan. Gayunpaman, alam ko na hindi lahat ng mga Palestinian ay sumusuporta sa Hamas. Sa katunayan, sila ay mapaparusahan ng matindi kung pinaghihinalaan man na hindi sumusuporta Hamas. Ipagdasal natin na matapos na ang digmaang ito at mapuksa ng Israel ang Hamas para makalaya ang mga Palestinian sa Hamas, he expressed. Ito ay isang kahila-hilakpot na sitwasyon tulad ng maiisip mo, sinabi niya sa CBN Digital. Lahat ng tao sa Gaza ay gustong makaalis sa Gaza ngayon. At habang ang mga mananampalataya ay sumilong, sila ay naubusan ng pagkain, tubig at mga panustos na medical. Idinagdag ni Rosenberg na sila ay talagang nakulong sa mga simbahan. Simula sa huling 24 na oras, ang IDF ay nag-utos sa mga Kristiyanong Palestinian, "Okay, ngayon kailangan mo talagang lumipat sa Timok dahil marami pang mga operasyon na kailangan nating gawin," sabi ni Rosenberg. Well, ang problema ay natatakot silang pumunta sa Timok dahil hindi sila Muslim. Sila ay mga Kristiyano at ang Hamas at Islamic Jihad at iba pang marahas, genocidal Islamist extremists ay papatayin ang mga Kristiyanong ito. Ipinagpatuloy niya, "Gahasayin nila ang mga asawa at mga anak na babae tulad ng ginawa nila sa Syria, sa Iraq, sa Afghanistan, kahit saan pa kung saan nagpapatakbo ang mga lalaking ito." Na maglaon, na-update ni Rosenberg na ang mga alalahaning ito tungkol sa kaligtasan, seguridad at kinabukasan ng mga Kristiyanong Palestinian na ito ay ngayon, sa katunayan, tinatalakay sa pinakamaas na antas ng gobyerno ng Israel. Ang parehong mga pinuno ng sibilyan at militar ng Israel, kabilang ang mga nasa kabinet ng digmaan at kabinete ng seguridad, ay napag-alaman at nagkaroon ng mga panloob na talakayan tungkol sa krisis na kinakaharap ng mga Kristiyano na nakakulong sa tatlong simbahan sa Gaza City, patuloy niya. Hindi ko may ulat sa oras na ito na ang isang desisyon ay ginawa tungkol sa kung paano magpatuloy. Ngunit ang bagay ay nasa screen ng kanilang radar. At ito ay isang magandang bagay, dagdag niya.
Come Holy Spirit, come Holy Spirit. Bless this unworthy priest that I may share with humility and with a heart, not just with the lips. And the people listen with the hearts, not just with the ears. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. Sisters and brothers, the storm, Paeng, has passed. No storm lasts forever. Lahat ng bagyo po dumadaan lang. So ano mang pinagdadaanan mo, daanan mo lang. Kaya nga pinagdadaanan. You know, the morning after the storm, you go out, you know, the whole day, the whole night, you're covered. You go out from your house and you see fallen trees and all that. Pero there's a new hope. Parang there's a lot of cleansing. Maraming na nawala pero hope, pag-asa. This morning, I just share with you yung Lord's, yung praise. Praising the Lord. Let the earth bless the Lord. Praise and exalt Him. Springs and new season, rivers, all the birds of the air, all you beasts, wild and tame, bless the Lord. All you winds, cold and chill, ice and snow, darkness, lightnings, clouds, bless the Lord. Where the Lord shows that He is in control of nature. The Lord of nature. By the way, on the side, paano nagkakaroon ng storm? It all starts with a weather disturbance. How do storms start in your life? May disturbance ka. If you don't handle that well, the next one is you have a low pressure area. Pressure. Marami sa atin nagkakabagyo si marami kang pressures. Whatever it is, personal or from other people or situation. Ah, and then LPA develops to a depression. Oh, may depression ka ba? Kasi meron ka sigurong disturbance, may pressure, depression na. Sana huminto na. Dediretso pa yung iba, nagiging storm signal na. May signal na siya. I forget the exact speed. Pero that depression becomes a storm. Bagyo na. Pwedeng signal number one, number two, number three. And then, kung hindi mo pa rin mahandal yung bagyo, naging typhoon. Tetum, big wind. That's what it means. So yun po, ano ang pinagdadaanang bagyo na may pinagsimulan yan? It's a disturbance, may pressure, depression. Kaya nagiging bagyo ka na, hindi lang bagyo, super bagyo pa pala, typhoon na. That's on the side, mga kapatid. But you know, everything is just passing by. Ang maganda today, our gospel is about Zacchaeus who heard that Jesus was passing by. Now, Zacchaeus made the effort to see Jesus. Well, Zacchaeus was number one. He was a big time sinner. He was chief tax collector. Tax collector. Getting taxes from the local people, from the Jews, for Rome. So, he was low stature, yung pangalawa. Maliit daw siya. Pero in the eyes ng mga kababayan niya, walang kwentang tao yan, traidor. So, mababang pagtingin nila. Ganun ang situation, no? But he could not see Jesus kasi he was small. So, what did he do? You know why he could not see Jesus? Ang ganda po sabi ng gospel. Could not see Jesus because of the crowd. Many times, why do we not see Jesus? Because of the crowd. What is your crowd? Who is your crowd? Your crowd is, you're so always nandun ka sa trabaho, nandun ka sa sosyalan, pasikatan, payabangan. That's your crowd. Unless you detach yourself from that, you can never really see Jesus. Kasi one-on-one dapat po eh. Think about that. Zacchaeus is teaching us lessons today. But who? What did he do? Hindi siya makatingin kay Jesus. So, he climbed up a sycamore tree because Jesus was passing that way. Inunahan na niya. Baka sakali makita niya. You see, the desire of this man who is condemned, who is known to be a big-time sinner, he really desired to see Jesus. As I speak, there are some of you who really desire in your heart to see Jesus, to meet Him. Ano mang sitwasyon mo, maybe you have problems, you have bad habits, etc. But deep inside, keep that desire burning. And that's what the Lord sees. Oh, yung mga those who are close to Jesus, right away nung nakita nila yung Zacchaeus na yan, judgmental sila agad. Parang wala man na, yung desire to be with Jesus, hindi na masyado nila kwa niyan eh. But there are people who really treasure, and there's some people who just take for granted a lot of things in their spirituality. Pride, spiritual pride. Anyway, mga kapatid, paalaala po. By the way, I think Zacchaeus should be the patron saint of government officials and elected officials. He was chief tax collector. Akala ko nabasa ko, thief. Parehong spelling yun, chief, saka thief. collector. What's the difference? Yung si, if you have Christ, you don't become a thief. Pwede kang maging chief. And he really went up to see Jesus. Why do you climb a tree? Nung bata kami, why do we climb trees? Well, it's nice to be up on a tree. You see the view. Number two, well, you can enjoy the fruits. Why do we can't climb trees? Hinahabol ka ng aso, akyat ka na doon. Saka, because that's where you see your refuge. This is exactly what Zacchaeus did. He sought refuge in that tree. And akala niya, hindi siya mapapansin. But guess what? This man whom he longed to stop. Right? And he was there looking. And what did Jesus do? Jesus looked up and said, Zacchaeus, can you imagine na affirm siya sa lahat ng mga chismosa at chismosa, huminto si Jesus. Zacchaeus, come down. I will eat in your house tonight. Whoa! Halos mahulog si Zacchaeus. Number one, first time somebody looked up to him. All the time, lahat ng mga tao, they look down on him. Maliit siya. Okay, Zacchaeus. This man looked up to him. Oh, this man knew his name. This man even said, uy, kakain ako sa bahay mo. Wow. And what did the Lord say? Today, salvation has come to this house. He was affirmed. He was not condemned. Today, may I ask all of us just to say again, Lord, you know, deep in my heart, I love you. I want to be good. Marami lang circumstances. Maybe the crowd. Maybe I'm not ready, but this Lord, you know that I love you. If you can only say that, it's good enough for the Lord. But look at this Zacchaeus. Hindi lang yun. What did he do? He came down from the tree. Mga iba sa atin kasi, we don't meet Jesus kasi you're still up on the tree. Pinababa ka na ni Lord. Kaya, thank you, Lord. Come down. Come down from your tree of pride, your tree of comfort and comfort zone. You cannot meet Jesus from the tree. You have to walk the earth and follow Him. So, na-complete yung repentance niya. What did he say? Listen to what Zacchaeus said. Huh? Behold, Lord, half of my possessions I will give to the poor. And if I have extorted anything from anyone, Lord, I shall pay it four times. Coming from a man, marunong magkwentas klaras ito eh. Collector siya eh. You see, he was not only a tax collector, but he was a wealthy man. Mayaman na siya. That's why you understand now why he said, half of my possessions I will give to the poor. Yung pinaghirapan ko talaga na unaman ako, kalahati nun ipapamigay ko na. And the next one said, kung meron kong mga kinurakot dyan, 4 times, ikikwits ko na yan. He knew what he's talking about. I'd like to ask you today, lalo na po yung mga, those who made money from people, extortion, whatever, you know, dirty money and unshared money, or those who are rich by inheritance, hard work, can you say, okay, Lord, for you, half of my possession. Compute mo nga. How much money you have? Kunwari may 10 million ka. Uy, 5 million. Eh. Ibigay ko na. But this man did it. Naku, yung mga dinaya po, mga inurakot ko, times 4. This was a man who knew what it meant. He not only came down from his comfort zone, from his sin, he went down Jesus and followed him from there on, became a follower. So, meron pong kwento kasi na 2 grandmothers, nagkwekwentuhan sila. Sabi ng isa, Lola, you know, every year, I send to my grandchildren a card and I insert a check, generous check to each one of my grandchildren. And then she said, but it's sad. They don't even text me back that they have received the check. They don't even visit me. And the other grandmother said, bakit? Well, I don't know. Me, sabi naman ng isa, I do the same. I give a card and I insert a check. But you know what? Within a week, they start calling me. They even visit me. And the first one said, how did you do that? Well, I insert the check, but I did not sign the check. Smart. Smart. But you see, Zacchaeus was not only playing smart. Papakita yan sa mga tao na, oh, ito, gawa-gawa lang ito yung pinagsasabi niya na I'm gift. No. I think this man was already not playing smart but playing hard. Puso na yan. And so it is many times, many of us go on living as playing smart. Managing things somehow, even managing God, but we never really play hard. My brothers and sisters, do as Zacchaeus, and you'll be free. The challenge is there. Sign up. Sign your name. Sign up in the Lord's army. Father, I'm in the Lord's army. I don't see you in church. Father, I'm in the secret service. Oh, no, no. God needs people of active as games. Please find your way. Remember this. It was humility. Number one, he desired to change. Alam niya eh, makasalanan siya. I desire really Number two, he said sorry. I'm sorry if I have offended anyone. Nag-sorry na siya. Not only that, he made amends. And giving half of my possessions, times four yung mga niloko ko, mga kinurakot ko, babayaran ko lahat yan. And he followed Jesus. Marami sa atin, we follow Jesus from the comfort of our homes. You have to walk the earth to really follow Jesus. My dear brothers and sisters, Zacchaeus, nahuli ni Lord. You know why? What happened? Because the Lord sought him. Hinanap siya ni Lord. The Son of Man came to seek and to save what is lost. The other side is this. Zacchaeus, nagpakita rin kay Lord. Sometimes the Lord cannot see you, cannot seek you because you don't show yourself. You stay in the crowd. You're anonymous. But when you go one-on-one with the Lord, that's it. What more can you say? It's time to do as a case, mga kapatid. All of us. So dear friends, nahuli na. Sino bang holy? Father, madasalin ako, holy ako, I'm prayerful. Not necessarily. I know many people are prayerful, but they don't live their prayers. Holy, you know who is holy? Holy ka kung nahuli ka na ni Lord. Lord, I'm yours na. Wala na. Everything is yours na. Then you are holy. There's still too much about you. It's all your agenda. Hindi ka pa holy. Sisters and brothers, let's pray with the grace to sana mahuli na tayo ni Lord. Oh, Prison Awareness Week. Prison Awareness Sunday. Nahuli. Sana mahuli ka na ni Lord. We pray for the prisoners, yes. You can encourage them. It's not easy. We visited. One of these corporal words of mercy is to visit the prisoners, okay? But question, baka naman ikaw ay prisoner. Zacchaeus was a POW. Prisoner of work. That work he was doing, na impresa. Prisoner of wealth. What are you? Prisoner of worry? Prisoner of wife? Or whatever? I don't know. Basta make sure lang that you don't become a prison to other people. Yung kinokontrol mo sila, ikaw ang dahilan, hindi na sila masaya. Is there anybody in your house that's your prison? Are you a prison? Do you imprison people? Sisters and brothers, we pray, Lord, set us free from our prisons. Set us free. Please, release me. Let me go from my vices, from my bad habits, from my pride, selfishness. And we remember also the All Saints Day, November. Sign up na. Remember the song? Tell the Lord today, Lord, oh Lord, I want to be in that number when the saints go marching in. Sign up. Zacchaeus, sign up. Become a saint. And please don't forget this. There is no sinner without a future. There is no saint without a past. Lahat po ng mga santo may pinagdaan, may nakaraan. There is hope for all of us. Who is your favorite saint? Dami, no? Oh, Saint Therese, October 1. Of course, Saint Ezekiel who healed my cancer. Excuse me po. Sino ang saint daw ng mga matataba? Sabi nila si Santa Rita de Casia. So, you know, the saints were not miserable people. They were happy people. You want to become a saint? Please be joyful. Spread joy. Baka ang santo mo, favorite saint mo, Santa Pera. Yan ang nagdi-devotion ka palagi sa kanya. Mga iba yan ang favorite nila, Santa Pera. Ang gusto man ng iba, Santa Bongga. Pabongga, pasikat, payabang, inikilala, popular. That's your saint. Yan ang sinasanto mo. Kaya hindi mo nakikita si Jesus. Or, ano pa? Whatever it is. Santa Loca. Naluloka ka sa good time. Naluloka ka sa mga alahas. Naluloka ka sa mga kain, etc. Choose your saint. And All Souls Day, eternal rest run unto them, O Lord, perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Rest in peace. Sana po, lahat tayo someday rest in peace in heaven. Baka naman namatay tayo, restless in purgatory. Or worse, rotting in the pit. This and that is their message to us. Your loved ones, I'll tell you, I'm okay, I'm with God, I'm home. Let that be a message for all of us, you who honor the dead. And they're telling us, oh, dito sa langit, walang problema, wala na dito mga issue. Wala dito mga mayayabang, mga matatapang, mga masusungit, wala. Wala sila dito, hindi sila nakakarating. Mga Marites, mga Bashes, mga... wala. So, be good and go to heaven. That's the first message. Number two, they tell us all again, thank you, salamat sa alaala, salamat sa pagmamahal. And I'm sure they would like to tell us, love one another. Magmahalan kayo, magtudungan, magpatawaran. Forget your love of money and power. Walang kwenta yan dito sa langit. The love of God. And finally, their message for all of us. See you in heaven. You better be good that you too will go to heaven. Sisters and brothers, life is short. May I honor Father Henry Sheng, SVD. He died 92 years old, 61 years as a priest, 42 years as a missionary in Mindoro. Father Sheng was a man, slow stature, maliit lang siya, but he was a spiritual giant. He did not build structures, chapels, kung ano-ano mga project dyan. No, He built communities. He built lives of people, mga pinag-aaral niyang scholars. Wow, something like that, mga kapatid. So, dear friends, life is short. So, number one, sign up to the Lord's army. Life is short. Do as chaos. Come down from your tree and follow the Lord. Jesus is passing your way. Please, huwag mong idadma when Jesus is passing your way. Welcome Him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for seeking the lost like me and saving the lost like me. Amen. We profess our...
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus, on leaving the house on a certain day, sat down by the lake shore. Such great crowds gathered around him that he went and took his seat in a boat. While the crowd stood along the shore, he addressed them at length in parables, speaking in this fashion. One day a farmer went out sowing. Part of what he saw landed on a footpath where birds came and ate it up. Part of it fell on rocky ground where it had little soil. It sprouted at once since the soil had no depth. But when the sun rose and scorched it, it began to wither for lack of roots. Again, part of the seed fell among thorns, which grew up and choked it. Part of it finally landed on good soil and yielded grain at 100, 60, or 30-fold. Let everyone heed what he hears. When the disciples got near him, they asked him, "Why do you speak to them in parables?" He answered, "To you has been given a knowledge of the mysteries of the reign of God, but it has not been given to the others. To the man who has, more will be given until he grows rich. The man who has not will lose what little he has. I use parables when I speak to them, because they look but do not see. They listen but do not hear or understand. Isaiah's prophecy is fulfilled in them, which says, 'Listen as you will, you shall not understand. Look intently as you will, you shall not see.' Sluggish indeed in this people's heart, they have scarcely heard with their ears, they have firmly closed their eyes, otherwise they might see what with their eyes and hear with their ears and understand with their hearts and turn back to me and I shall heal them. But blessed are your eyes because they see, and blessed are your ears because they hear. I assure you, many a prophet and many a saint longed to see what you see but did not see it, to hear what you hear but did not hear it. Mark well then the parable of the sower. The seed along the path is the man who hears the message about God's reign without understanding it. The evil one approaches him to steal away what was sown in his mind. The seed that fell on patches of rock is the man who hears the message at first, receive it with joy, but he has no roots, so he lasts only for a time. When some setback or persecution involving the message occurs, he soon falters. What was sown among briars is the man who hears the message, but then worldly anxiety and the lure of money choke it off. Such a one produces no yield. But what was sown on good soil is the man who hears the message and take it in. He it is who bears a yield of 100, 60, or 30-fold. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Come, Holy Spirit, bless this unworthy priest, that I may share with humility and with the heart, and that people listen with humility, with the Holy Spirit in their hearts. Come, Holy Spirit. He says, brothers, the Lord is happy you are here today. Umulan, bumagyo, ayos lang. Lord, reporting for duty. Pwede po bang palakpakan kayong lahat, your effort to be here? Remember, God is happy with every little thing we do. He appreciates that too. And He's also happy if, aside from reaching out to Him, we reach out to one another. Oh, pakitignan mo ngayon katabi mo at sabihin mo na sa kanya, I'm happy you are here. Happy we're still alive. Happy we're together. Advance Merry Christmas na. Oh, more personal naman. Pakitanong mo naman yung pangalan niya. Ano bang pangalan mo? Taga saan po kayo? This is family. This is worship. And today, ito medyo personal. Pakita nung mga yung katabi mo, ano ba ang height mo? Tignan natin kung nag-grow ka na. Oh, level up, isa pang question. Ano bang weight mo? Naku, musobra na yan, Father. Last na lang. Sabi mo na lang, by the way, how old are you? Yeah. Getting to know you and to make sure that you are good soil. You know, I just came from Davao, had a mass in Sacred Heart, in Obrero. What a wonderful experience with the Davaoenos. And I ate not durian, marang. Wow! Marang has many seeds. Ang daming buto. Well, talking about seeds, Have you heard of Attis? Attis therapy for husbands and wives. Try it. So one time we told somebody to plant Attis. Why? Why, Father? You'll be happy. Why? Tell me. Can somebody talk while eating Attis? Kaya kung maingay si Mrs., maingay si Mr., pakainin mo ng Attis. Attis therapy. Hindi na makapagsalita. So this husband planted, waited for 3 years. Finally, the Attis tree bore fruit. Pero nung binigay, Diyos ko po, seedless pala yung Attis. Sisters and brothers, talking about seeds, the gospel today talks about the good seed, the Word of God. Who are we? We are the soil, the ground. The seed is good, but the ground must be rich so that there will be harvest. Well, some seeds fell on the pathway, yung daanan, the place for busy people. It's hard for the seed of God's word or God's call to grow if you're busy. No time, Father. No time. No thanks. I have more important things to do. Kuno. Sisters and brothers, take time, make time to listen to God if you really want to grow. Maybe you will grow financially, but you will not grow spiritually. You have emptiness, no time. And there are some people who say, no, outright rejection of God. I don't know why. Pride. I don't need anyone. Kapatid, remember this. There is a God, and you're not Him. Wala pong mayabang sa Diyos sa oras ng kamatayan. No proud people at the moment of death. Busy. Oh, there's a story about the vice mayor who was asked by the press, "Sir, are you busy, sir?" "No, no, no. I'm mayor, huh? I'm not busy. Don't forget that. I call the BCBP. I encountered them many times. Brotherhood of Christian... Professional. Can somebody supply that? BCBP. Anyway, I paraphrase them. You are BC but prayerful. Keep that in mind. What if God told you at the end of your life, "What's your name?" "This is my name." And that said, "Oh, sorry, I was too busy, I did not write your name." But let's make time. Second, rocky ground. Rocky, full of rocks. Siga. But not much soil. When we made the sanctuarium on the side, we had plants there, But I didn't realize what they did was cemented that pathway and put little soil. When the rains came, voila, voila rin. Make sure that you are soil. May soil ka, panay ka rake. You're a rock star, whatever, but wala kang soil. Soil, by the way, Latin word is humus. Hence, humility. Be humble. Don't be a rocky person. Thorny. The thorny path. You grow, the word of God grows, but soon you are choked by worries, anxieties of this world. That's what happens to many of us. When temptations come, wala na. Be strong. And there are those that fall on good soil. Good soil and produce 10, 15, 20, 100 fruits, depending again on your cooperation. Today I'm very happy for a fruitful harvest for the Society of the Divine Word. We had 12 priests who said yes to God and let that seed grow. Not only that, of the 12 priests of Kenosis class who were ordained last February 4, six are going to the foreign missions. That's really something, huh? Pang-export quality. It's hard to be uprooted again. Mahirap po. And I'm very happy to present to you today. They're here. Father Reynaldo Regalado. Father, will you stand? From Ligao, Albay, going to Central America. Good seed, Father. Thank you. And Father Peter Bulosan from Pasukin, Ilocos Norte, going to Kenya, Africa. And Father Joe Marie Berme, 6'2", from Claveria, Cagayan, going to Argentina, South. And Father Ronnie Pinca from Laoang, Northern Samar, going to Spain. Good seed bearing fruit because they said yes. They took time. They gave up. They sacrificed. And last but not the least, we have here with us a missionary who spent 38 years in Ghana, Africa. Father Joseph Panabang from Kalinga. Thank you. You see, the seed has borne fruit. Nagbunga po. And you and I can do the same in our own way. So, don't say no to God. Or say, no thanks. No thanks. Oy, polite naman. No thanks. Or you say, no time. No time for you. At saka, no profit. Wala namang market value. Yung pagdasal-dasal na yan. What does it profit you to gain the whole world and you lose your soul? Or no fun. That's no fun, going to church, listening to God. sisters and brothers, fun is not what's outside you. Joy. You will have joy if you have God in your life. Brothers and sisters, sana po, lahat tayo we say, no retreat, no surrender. Lord, I am here. In spite of me, I am a sinner and all, but I'll not retreat, I'll not surrender. So, we end with BTS. Believe, trust, surrender. We will follow you, Lord, no matter what. We are all weak. Wala namang 100% follower. But we keep trying. Keep it up. Don't give up. Just hold on. Have faith in your heart. For my love will see you through. My love will see you through. Wala na naman mga senior moments ito. Anyway, mga kapatid, there's one line in the Bible. Listen to this. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. It is the word of God that will help us journey through life. Psalm 119. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. One thing I noticed with many people, alam po nyo, we get many problems, stress, pressures. You know, picture this. Many people, because of problems and all, their heads are bowed. Imagine this is the water level. If your head is bowed with all this word decay, you cannot breathe. So what do? You just look up and your nose is above seawater. You get the picture? Kaya hindi ka masyado sinagalagi kang nakatutok sa problema mo, sa pera mo, sa mga kung ano-ano. And what happens is you cannot breathe. Your nose is below water. But if you take time to look up, your nose is above water now. That's the power of prayer. That's the power of listening to the Word of God. Please don't forget the up-look. Up-look na tayo? Don't forget that. And you know, many people also have their nose down. Why? Because many of us are looking at our cell phone. Itong mundo mo. And many of us forget even to look up to God. Karamihan daw, looking down palagi, you're looking because for you, the most important thing is your gadget and your budget. Look up. There is a God who tells us, your world is not this. Don't make this your world. Fine, it's helpful and all, but please put down those gadgets when there are people with you. Especially when you're eating. When somebody's with me and just doing this the whole time, I just stand up. What for? What am I doing here? Nobody's talking with me. Di po ba? Please be kind to yourself. Be kind to people around you. These things can wait. That person beside you maybe is going through pain, trials. Tignan mo nga natin ang side look. Tignan mo nga pa side look na tayo. Pinahan mo naman yan. Oh, yan. Side look and up look. Mga kapatid, today we say thank you to the Lord. And thank you. Lord, thank you for all the people who plant the seed on us. Our parents, teachers, friends who reminded us of God, all of them, maraming salamat po. Remember Johnny Apple Seed. We read about it in elementary, about why are there so many apples all over America. So according to this story, there was this one man who kept walking, sowing seeds everywhere he went. Nagkaroon ng maraming apple. And why are there many nuts, trees, and all that? There's many squirrels. They gather the seeds and they hide them somewhere and then they forget where it is. Tumutubo na rin. Maybe that's the word for all of us here. Be an apple seed spread. And just keep spreading the good news, the joy, and even forget. Don't keep record of the goodness you have done. Just keep doing it. God will take care of the rest. Hindi mahirap po yung, I did good, ha? Pero niyo pong kakalimutan. O, dito ko. That's not good enough. No, no. Just do it with joy, humility. And this is our mission, wherever we go. Whether you go to Africa, whether you go to Kamuning or Cubao, wherever. There, after the Mass, you go and spread joy and hope that we are also sowers of the seed. Not just good soil, but sowers also. And today, may I ask all of us to bow our heads and ask the Lord, Lord, help us to say yes to you. Especially in times when it's difficult to say yes. Whenever we feel like saying, Lord, I have no time. Lord, it's not fun. Lord, there's no profit, no value. Lord, teach me to say, yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I'm grateful, Lord. Mama Mary, the woman who said yes. Today, Feast of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. We place ourselves under your special protection. Thank you for this scapula to remind us that whoever wears this scapula will be under your special protection. Whoever dies wearing this scapula, Mama Mary will see to it that this person to go to heaven. Mama Mary, thank you po. Help us to be more open to God's will. And help us not to be just hearers of the word, but doers of the word. Remind us that after listening, may we also go to serve. Koinonia, going to diakonia, and going to kerygma, proclamation, spreading the faith. Let's all pray to Mama Mary today. Hail Mary, full of grace. Lord, may the seed of your word, of your call, not be wasted. May I respond to your word and to your call. Amen and amen.
Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus came to Jericho and intended to pass through the town. Now, a man there named Zacchaeus, who was a chief tax collector and also a wealthy man, was seeking to see who Jesus was, but he could not see him because of the crowd, for he was short in stature. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore tree in order to see Jesus, who was about to pass that way. When he reached the place, Jesus looked up and said, "Zacchaeus, come down quickly, for today I must stay at your house." Zacchaeus came down quickly and received Jesus with joy. When they all saw this, they began to grumble, saying, "He has gone to stay at the house of a sinner." But Zacchaeus stood there and said to the Lord, "Behold, half of my possessions, Lord, I shall give to the poor. And if I have extorted anything from anyone, I shall repay it four times over." And Jesus said to him, "Today, salvation has come to this house, because this man, too, is a descendant of Abraham. For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save what was lost." Sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. Bless this unworthy priest that I may share with humility and with the heart, not just with the lips. And that people listen with the hearts, not just with the ears. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. Sisters and brothers, the storm Paeng has passed. No storm lasts forever. Lahat ng bagyo po dumadaan lang. So ano mang pinagdadaanan mo, daanan mo lang. Kaya nga pinagdadaanan. You know, the morning after the storm, you go out, you know, the whole day, the whole night, you're covered. You go out from your house and you see fallen trees and all that. Pero there's a new hope. Parang there's a lot of cleansing. Maraming na nawala, pero hope, pag-asa. This morning, I can share with you yung Lord's, yung praise. Praising the Lord. Let the earth bless the Lord. Praise and exalt Him. Springs and new seas and rivers, all the birds of the air, all you beasts, wild and tame, bless the Lord. All you winds, cold and chill, ice and snow, darkness, lightnings, clouds, bless the Lord. Where the Lord shows that He is in control of nature, the Lord of nature. By the way, on the side, paano nagkakaroon ng storm? It all starts with a weather disturbance. How do storms start in your life? May disturbance ka. If you don't handle that well, the next one is you have a low pressure area. Pressure. Marami sa atin nagkakabagyo, marami kang pressures. Whatever it is. Personal or from other people or situation. Ah. And then, LPA develops to a depression. Oh, may depression ka ba? Kasi meron ka sigurong disturbance, may pressure, depression na. Sana huminto na, dediretso pa yung iba, nagiging storm signal na. May signal na siya. I forget the exact speed. Pero, that depression becomes a storm. Bagyo na. Pwedeng signal number one, number two, number three. And then, kung hindi mo pa rin mahandal, yung bagyo naging typhoon. Typhoon. Big wind. That's what it means. So yun po, ano mang pinagdadaan mong bagyo, may pinagsimulan yan. Usually, disturbance, may pressure, depression. Kaya nagiging bagyo ka na, hindi lang bagyo, super bagyo pa pala, typhoon na. That's on the side, mga kapatid. But you know, everything is just passing by. Ang maganda today, our gospel is about Zacchaeus who heard that Jesus was passing by. Now, Zacchaeus made the effort to see Jesus. Well, Zacchaeus was number one, he was a big time sinner. He was chief tax collector. Tax collector. Getting taxes from the local people, from the Jews, or Rome. So, he was of low stature, yung pangalawa. Maliit daw siya. Pero in the eyes ng mga kababayan niya, walang kwentang tao yan, traidor. So, mababang pagtingin nila. Ganun ang situation, no? But he could not see Jesus kasi he was small. So, what did he do? You know why he could not see Jesus? Ang ganda po sabi ng gospel. Could not see Jesus because of the crowd. Many times, why do we not see Jesus? Because of the crowd. What is your crowd? Who is your crowd? Your crowd is, you're so always, nandun ka sa trabaho, nandun ka sa sosyalan, pasikatan, payabangan. That's your crowd. Unless you detach yourself from that, you can never really see Jesus. Kasi one-on-one dapat po eh. Think about that. Zacchaeus is teaching us lessons today. But who? What did he do? Hindi siya makatingin kay Jesus. So, he climbed up a sycamore tree because Jesus was passing that way. Inunahan na niya. Baka sakali makita niya. You see, the desire of this man who is condemned, who is known to be a big time sinner, he really desired to see Jesus. As I speak, there's some of you who really desire in your heart to see Jesus, to meet Him. Ano mang sitwasyon mo, maybe you have problems, you have bad habits, etc. But deep inside, keep that desire burning. And that's what the Lord sees. So, yung mga those who are close to Jesus, right away nung nakita nila yung Zacchaeus na yan, judgmental sila agad. Parang wala man na, yung desire to be with Jesus, hindi na masyado nila kanyan eh. But there are people who really treasure, and there's some people who just take for granted a lot of things in their spirituality. Pride, spiritual pride. Anyway, mga kapatid, paalaala po. By the way, I think Zacchaeus should be the patron saint of government officials and elected officials. He was chief tax collector. Akala ko nabasa ko, thief. Parehong spelling yun, chief, saka thief, tax collector. What's the difference? Yung C, if you have Christ, you don't become a thief. Pwede kang maging chief. And he really went up to see Jesus. Why do you climb a tree? Nung bata kami, why do we climb trees? Well, it's nice to be up on a tree. You see, the view. Number two, well, you can enjoy the fruits. Why do we climb trees? Hinahabol ka ng aso, akyat ka na doon. Because that's where you see your refuge. This is exactly what Zacchaeus did. He sought refuge in the tree. And akala niya, hindi siya mapapansin. But guess what? This man whom he longed to stop. And he was there looking. And what did Jesus do? Jesus looked up and said, Zacchaeus, can you imagine? Na-affirm siya na lahat ng mga chismosa, huminto si Jesus. Zacchaeus, come down. I will eat in your house tonight. Whoa! Halos mahulog si Zacchaeus. Number one, first time somebody looked up to him. All the time, lahat ng mga tao, they looked down on him. Maliit siya. Okay, Zacchaeus. This man looked up to him. Whoa! This man knew his name. This man even said, uy, kakain ako sa bahay mo. Wow! And what did the Lord say? Today, salvation has come to this house. He was affirmed. He was not condemned. Today, may I ask all of us just to say again, Lord, you know, deep in my heart, I love you. I want to be good. Marami lang circumstances. Maybe the crowd. Maybe I'm not ready. But please, Lord, you know that I love you. If you can only say that, it's good enough for the Lord. But look at this Zacchaeus. Hindi lang yon. What did he do? He came down from the tree. Mga iba sa atin kasi, we don't meet Jesus kasi you're still up on the tree. Pinababa ka na ni Lord. Thank you, Lord. Come down. Come down from your tree of pride, your tree of comfort and comfort zone. You cannot meet Jesus from the tree. You have to walk the earth and follow Him. So na-complete yung repentance niya. What did He say? Listen to what Zacchaeus said. Huh? Behold, Lord, half of my possessions I will give to the poor. And if I have extorted anything from anyone, Lord, I shall pay it four times. Coming from a man, marunong magkwentas klaras ito eh. Tax collector siya eh. You see, he was not only a tax collector, but he was a wealthy man. Mayaman na siya. That's why you understand now why I said, half of my possessions, I will give to the poor. Yung pinaghirapan ko talaga na, naman ako, kalahati nun, ipapamigay ko na. And the next one said, kung mayroon kong mga kinurakot dyan, four times, ikikwits ko na yan. He knew what he's talking about. I'd like to ask you today, lalo na po yung mga, those who made money from people, extortion, whatever, you know, dirty money and unshared money. Or those who are rich by inheritance, hard work, Can you say, okay, Lord, for you, half of my possession. Compute mo nga. How much money you have? Kunwari may 10 million ka. Uy, 5 million. Eh. Ipigay ko na. But this man did it. Naku, yung mga dinaya ko, mga kinurakot ko, times 4. This was a man who knew what it meant. He not only came down from his comfort zone, from his sin, he went down, Jesus, and followed him from there on. Became a follower. So, meron pong kwento kasi na two grandmothers, nagkwekwentuhan sila. Sabi ng isa, Lola, you know, every year, I send to my grandchildren a card and I insert a check, generous check to each one of my grandchildren. And then she said, but it's sad. They don't even text me back that they have received the check. They don't even visit me. And the other grandmother said, bakit? Well, I don't know. Me, sabi naman ng isa, I do the same. I give a card and I insert a check. But you know what? Within a week, they start calling me. They even visit me. And the first one said, how did you do that? Well, I insert the check, but I did not sign the check. Smart. Smart. But you see, Zacchaeus was not only playing smart. Papakita niya sa mga tao na, oh, ito, gawa-gawa lang ito yung pinagsasabi niya na I'm give. No. I think this man was already not playing smart, but playing hard. Puso na. And so it is many times, many of us go on living as playing smart. Managing things somehow, even managing God, but we never really play hard. My brothers and sisters, do as Zacchaeus, and you'll be free. The challenge is there. Sign up. Sign your name. Sign up in the Lord's army. Father, I'm in the Lord's army. I don't see you in church. Father, I'm in the secret service. Oh, no. God needs people of active escapes. Please find your way. Remember this. It was humility. Number one, he desired to change. Alam niya eh, makasalanan siya. I desire really. Number two, he said sorry. I'm sorry if I have offended anyone. Nag-sorry na siya. Not only that, he made amends. And giving half of my possessions, times four yung mga niloko ko, mga kinurakot ko, babayaran ko lahat siya. And he followed Jesus. Marami sa atin, we follow Jesus from the comfort of our homes. You have to walk the earth to really follow Jesus. Now, dear brothers and sisters, si Zacchaeus, nahuli ni Lord. You know why? What happened? Because the Lord sought him. Hinanap siya ni Lord. The Son of Man came to seek and to save what is lost. The other side is this. Zacchaeus, nagpakita rin kay Lord. Sometimes, the Lord cannot see you, cannot seek you because you don't show yourself. You stay in the crowd. You're anonymous. But when you go one-on-one with the Lord, that's it. What more can you say? It's time to do as a case, mga kapatid. All of us. So, dear friends, nahuli na. Sino bang holy? Father, madasalin ako. Holy ako. I'm prayerful. Not necessarily. I know many people are prayerful, but they don't live their prayers. Holy, you know who is holy? Holy ka kung nahuli ka na ni Lord. Lord, I'm yours na. Wala na. Everything is yours na. Then you are holy. There's still too much about you. It's all your agenda. Hindi ka pa holy. Sisters and brothers, let's pray for the grace to sana mahuli na tayo ni Lord. Oh, Prison Awareness Week. Prison Awareness Sunday. Nahuli. Sana mahuli ka na ni Lord. We pray for the prisoners, yes. We can encourage them. It's not easy. We've visited. One of these corporal works of mercy is to visit the prisoners, okay? But question, baka naman ikaw ay prisoner. Zacchaeus was a POW. prisoner of work, that work he was doing, na impresa. Prisoner of wealth. What are you? Prisoner of worry? Prisoner of wife? Or whatever? I don't know. Basta make sure lang that you don't become a prison to other people. Yung kinokontrol mo sila, ikaw ang dahilan, hindi na sila masaya. Is there anybody in your house that's your prison? Are you a prison? Do you imprison people? Sisters and brothers, we pray, Lord, set us free from our prisons. Set us free. Please, release me. Let me go. From my vices, from my bad habits, from my pride, selfishness. And we remember also the All Saints Day, November. Sign up na. Remember the song? Tell the Lord today, Lord. Oh Lord, I want to be in that number when the saints go marching in. Sign up. Zacchaeus, sign up. Become a saint. And please don't forget this. There is no sinner without a future. There is no saint without a past. Lahat po ng mga santo may pinagdaan, may nakaraan. There is hope for all of us. Who is your favorite saint? Dami, no? Oh, St. Therese, October 1. Of course, St. Ezekiel healed my cancer. Excuse me po, sino ang saint daw ng mga matataba? Sabi nila si Santa Rita de Casia. So, you know, the saints were not miserable people. They were happy people. You want to become a saint? Please be joyful. Spread joy. Baka ang santa mo, favorite saint mo, Santa Pera. Yan ang nagdi-devotion ka palagi sa kanya. Mga iba yan ang favorite nila, Santa Pera. Ang gusto naman ng iba, Santa Bongga. Pabongga, pasikat, payabang, kinikilala, popular. That's your saint. Yan ang sinasanto mo. Kaya hindi mo nakikita si Jesus. Or, ano pa? Whatever it is, Santa Loka. Naluloka ka sa good time, naluloka ka sa mga alahas, naluloka ka sa mga kain, etc. Choose your saint. And All Souls Day, eternal rest run unto them, O Lord, perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Rest in peace. Sana po, lahat tayo someday, rest in peace in heaven. Baka naman, namatay tayo, restless in purgatory, or worse, rotting in the pit of hell. Sisters and brothers, their message to us, your loved ones, I'll tell you, I'm okay, I'm with God, I'm home. Let that be a message for all of us, you who honor the dead. And they're telling us, oh, dito sa langit, walang problema, wala na dito mga issue. Wala dito mga mayayabang, mga matatapang, mga masusungit. Wala sila dito, hindi sila nakakarating. Mga Marites, mga Basias, mga wala. So, be good and go to heaven. That's the first message. Number two, they tell us all again, thank you, salamat sa alaala, salamat sa pagmamahal. And I'm sure they would like to tell us, love one another. Magmahalan kayo, magtudungan, magpatawaran. Forget your love of money and power. Walang kwenta yan dito sa langit. The love of God. And finally, their message for all of us. See you in heaven. You better be good, that you too will go to heaven. Sisters and brothers, life is short. May I honor Father Henry Shen, SVD. He died 92 years old, 61 years as a priest, 42 years as a missionary in Mindoro. Father Shen was a man, slow stature, maliit lang siya, but he was a spiritual giant. He did not build structures, chapels, kung ano-ano mga project yan. No, he built communities. He built lives of people, mga pinag-aaral niyang scholars. Wow, something like that, mga kapatid. So dear friends, life is short. So number one, sign up to the Lord's army. Life is short. Do as Zacchaeus. Come down from your tree and follow the Lord. Jesus is passing your way. please, huwag mong idedma when Jesus is passing your way. Welcome Him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for seeking the lost like me and saving the lost like me. Amen. Amen. We profess, I'll not retreat, I'll not surrender. So, we end with BTS. Believe, trust, surrender. We will follow you, Lord, no matter what. We are all weak. Wala namang 100% follower. But we keep trying. Keep it up. Don't give up. Just hold on. Have faith in your heart. For my love will see you through. My love will see you through. Wala na naman mga senior moments ito. Anyway, mga kapatid, this one line in the Bible. Listen to this. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. It is the word of God that will help us journey to life. Psalm 119. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. One thing I noticed with many people, alam po nyo, we get many problems, stress, pressures. You know, picture this. Many people, because of problems and all, their heads are bowed. Imagine this is the water level. If your head is bowed with all this worldly care, you cannot breathe. So what do? You just look up and your nose is above seawater. You get the picture? Kaya hindi ka masyado kinakalagi kang nakatutok sa problema mo, sa pera mo, sa mga kung ano-ano. And what happens is you cannot breathe. Your nose is below water. But if you take time to look up, your nose is above water now. That's the power of prayer. That's the power of listening to the Word of God. Please don't forget the up-look. Up-look na tayo? Don't forget that. And you know, many people also have their nose down. Why? Because many of us are looking at our cellphone. Itong mundo mo. And many of us forget even to look up to God. Karamihan daw, looking down palagi, you are looking because for you, the most important thing is your gadget and your budget. Look up. There is a God who tells us, your world is not this. Don't make this your world. Fine, it's helpful and all, but please put down those gadgets when there are people with you. Especially when you're eating. When somebody's with me and just doing this the whole time, I just stand up. What for? What am I doing here? Nobody's talking with me. Di po ba? Please be kind to yourself. Be kind to people around you. These things can wait. The person beside you maybe is going through pain, trials. Tignan mo nga natin ang side look. Tignan mo nga pa side look na tayo. Hinahango naman yan. O, yan. Side look and up look. Mga kapatid, today we say thank you to the Lord. And thank you. Lord, thank you for all the people who plant the seed on us. Our parents, teachers, friends who reminded us of God. All of them. Maraming salamat po. Remember...